So I thought I'd talk about honor systems in conduct, specifically online conduct. And the ground rule I'd have to lay down is honor systems in online conduct as they relate to people who use their real identities, their real personas, you know. Nobody who's assuming a sock account or something else, but people who put their real faces out there and are essentially as themselves as the medium allows them to be. Whether they do art videos or straight-up vlogs or anything, I'm not so concerned about the type of thing they do, which is just an angle of presentation, like a channel into the person that they are. But as long as the pieces that they put out there are reasonably genuine, are reasonably intact representations of who they are. Honor systems. I put forth that nobody would intentionally be themselves in order to not be themselves, in order to lie, to cheat, to attack. If you're going to be yourself, you want to conduct yourself in a way that has at least allow you to have a video camera and a computer and a desk, you know, and the things that are less common amongst perennial cheaters and liars and wrongdoers and evil people. Although, the argument could be made, look at big business, you know, look at Hollywood, look at all the evil people that exist who have vast wealth. Well, fine, but do they vlog? Are they out there making videos saying, hey, I screwed over this corporation today? No. Amongst people who vlog and they present themselves on these small social websites and try to open up pieces of themselves to learn, to share, to explore. Of those people, representing honesty, at least being true to yourself, I would wager, is fairly important. Because what's the point of doing it otherwise? There are no actual gains to be had. You're not getting paid for doing it. You know, no monetary incentives. The incentive is social interaction, getting something off your chest, and maybe even as a form of therapy to create something, you know, to create something and have it done and present it. The uploading of a creative video is finishing to an extent, you know. You can take it back and edit it later if you want, but it is a stage complete, at least. So, when we share those pieces of ourselves, and honesty being one of the precepts, you know, that we want in order to get anywhere, in order to make any progress, what do you do when you meet someone who's very likely in the gray area of honesty? They're not being dishonest, but they're willingly, perhaps, believing a system that lets them be more at ease with themselves. They're telling themselves stories, in essence. So instead of telling us stories, which would be more of a fabrication, they're telling themselves stories based in root compounds of reality, but twisted so that they're nice stories to believe in. And I guess we have that capacity always to do. You know, if you're in times in trouble, if you're trapped in a building, you know, you want to tell yourself, we're going to make it, you know, I'm going to find a way, I'm going to pull through, you know, the rescue's coming, whatever. But if you're just doing it to cope with online life, there is a questionable area, you know, something that's worthy of at least a moment's exploration, a moment's forethought before it continues, right? If you need to feel that other people are evil, if you feel the need to represent other people as being scum because they've done things you personally disagree with, well, who are you to ascribe the sum total of their being as evil or as scum? I think you're a pretty fucked up person, actually. Because common sense simply dictates that all that you see online are little shards or little fragments. You catch somebody on a bad day, you're very likely to see a bad fragment. You know, vlogging opens up that. If you're willing to do it, if you're willing to share, just like comedy, comedy is easy to attack because comedy is not a war. Comedy's not going to fire back at you, per se. except within the realm of comedy. You can attack it viciously, just as you would someone who harmed you or a family member. Fucker, fucker, horrible, scum, evil, blah, blah, blah. And what can comedy do? It's going to stay within the realm of comedy, even though you may choose to attack it in ungentlemanly, unflatteringly, you know, just inhuman ways. Really. I want to say it's human nature to attack like that, but a lot of it is just monstrous. Kind of fucked up psyche does that. Fucked up psyche doesn't realize the boundaries and parameters, the differences between online and life, the differences between a contained argument and then taking that to represent everything. We encounter that from time to time, and it's still, you know, it's a frustrating thing for me to encounter because it's not particularly grounded in any universal reasoning. It's grounded in a proprietary, personal reasoning. And you have to sort of guess as to what the other person's proprietary, personal reasonings are. And you can look at it and say, well, you know, I think I know where they're going. You know, I think I can sort of see what they're trying to say. And then they do it again, and you get a little further away from understanding. And then they attack somebody else, and they attack somebody else. And it just distances you from a point of reference, from a point of understanding. And one of the more harmful elements is to encourage that, or to turn a blind eye, or to sympathize with that, to pay false, oh yes, it must be so horrible for you to live your life claiming that you're attacked by people of such utter worthlessness. Oh yes, let's do something to build you up. Why? Isn't that, in and of itself, a little game, a little ring around the rosy that you're playing, buying in to the hot pot of shit that somebody wants you to eat? And not eating the pot, mind you, like they are, taking a taste and saying, oh yes, well, what an interesting recipe you've made there. Good job. I don't think that does anything helpful in the long run. In the long run, I think it condones and perpetuates. And people who feel guilty, people who are unable to call bullshit. Calling bullshit is necessary sometimes, and usually when it happens, and it happens frequently, it's not necessarily focused on the right things. You know, if somebody is a bullshit crusader, bullshit here and bullshit there, and hey, 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 you bullshit, bullshit, hey, 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 bullshit, bullshit, liar, evil scum, bullshit, well, what's the worth of their lives if that's their major occupation? I don't want to be the toxic avenger, you know. I don't want to have a cape behind me declaring how horrible everybody is, and then how badly I've been treated. What the fuck kind of life is that? And to encourage that, oh yes, tell us more. I mean, tell us more about how badly you've been treated and how horrible everybody is. Spew more shit from your worthless lips, and we will praise it as if they were nickels. As if they were dimes, as if they were quarters in our little casino of social interaction. No, I don't get that at all. I think that's part of the problem. How is anybody going to turn around and realize that what they're doing is bullshit if people are too chicken shit to call bullshit when it's done repeatedly over a period of time? Instead, of course, they jump on the one-sided perspective. You know, if there's only one person raging and depicting things a certain way, that's all that's going to be represented about those particular things. So, of course, hey, jump on this bandwagon. Why not? You know, be friends with somebody who's a total, vocal douchebag. Why not? Why not be friends with the loudmouth douchebag? Because if you are, deep down you know, you've just given yourself a free pass from attack. Yes, yes, you incredible pussy, that's what you've done. you won't be attacked because you've proffered, you've showed deference to the giant flaming douchebag. Why? I don't understand that. In the long run, there's no benefit, because the flaming douchebag will always be flaming about something. So it'll come around, and you stand a decent chance of being the target, of being yourself, evil and worthless and a waste. That's the risk you take by encouraging that behavior. Now maybe you want to say, I'm only going to focus on the non-douchebaggery, only going to focus on the hearts and flowers and an occasional positive behavior. Can't you look at it as a whole, you know? If you're chopping it up, and you're already looking at a pretty chopped up thing, if you're chopping it up even further and saying, cut, 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 oh, I found something nice, therefore, that's all that person is. Nice. No, I can be an asshole, you can be an asshole. What are the differences? Well, we each have our own different ways. And I'd like to think that I'm not an asshole when I call shit like this. Although, of course, I will be portrayed as being an asshole for calling shit like this. I understand that. How we represent ourselves. Patterns of abuse. Time is a very telling factor. If somebody is frequently attacking, harassing, slandering, left, right, you know, this person, that person, a list of people, that ought to tell you something, right? And instead of tooting the parade, building up something that cannot be fixed, somebody who's, for example, perennially ill, telling people that they have 2 years to live, and then 2 years later, I have 2 years to live. Oh, this is terminal. Oh, that's terminal. Pity me. I need help. Look at how I'm attacked. Oh, all these bullies. Oh, if I were only better. Oh, in my heyday, I could do this. Oh, I'm so fucking important. Don't tell me to do this. I'm better than you. Oh, blah, blah, blah. It's a problem. It turns off ability to be creative. It kills ability to share pieces of oneself, at least a certain segment, if you know they are subject to that kind of heartless, pointless, numbskullery of attacks. Condoning it creates division. All the happy horseshit you might want to pump ultimately ignores the problem.